is Tony Palias, and you're watching ilearnthings.com, episode 6, Selection Shortcuts. In this episode, we'll go over some keyboard shortcuts you can use to make your life easier when selecting cells in an OpenOffice.org spreadsheet. These shortcuts will come in handy when working with large files that contain thousands of rows, where it might not be feasible to select cells one by one. Selection is important when applying formatting, cutting and pasting values, and using formulas to calculate new values. The selection shortcuts used in this tutorial can be applied to any one of these scenarios. The most basic form of selection is to left-click on a cell. Each time you click on a new cell, that new cell is selected. If you want to select adjacent cells, click on the first cell you want highlighted. Hold down the Shift key on the keyboard and click on the last cell you want highlighted. The farther apart the two cells are, the more cells will be selected in total. To select non-adjacent cells, hold down the Control key on the keyboard and select the cells you want highlighted. By switching between both the Shift key and the Control key on the keyboard, you can select a combination of adjacent and non-adjacent cells. Another technique you can use to select adjacent cells is simply to click and drag the cells that you want selected. If you want to select all the cells in a page, click on the region between the column heading and the row numbers in the corner above cell A1. Keyboard shortcut for selecting all cells on a page is Control A. Selecting entire rows or columns can be done in a similar manner by selecting either the row number or the column letter. If you're in a cell, you can use the keyboard shortcut Control Shift Arrow. If the cells you're trying to select have data in them, then the selection stops at the last cell with information. You can repeat the shortcut again to select the entire row or column. So let's apply what we've learned so far. We'll try to use shortcuts we learned to apply some background color formatting. First, select all the cells on the page and apply light gray background. Then select the table heading and apply a white background. Next, select some non-adjacent cells and change the font color to red. Now select the entire bottom row and change the background to black and the font color to white. That's pretty much it for selection, but before I let you go, I'm going to show you a neat trick. If you need to make complicated selections, sometimes it's easier to move the cells. For example, let's say we want every third row to have a blue background. Instead of manually selecting every third row, where it would be easy to make a mistake, create two new columns. In the first column, number the rows sequentially. In the second column, number the first three rows, 1, 2, 3, and copy-paste these values for the remaining rows. Next, apply a descending sort to the second column you created. Highlight all the rows which are labeled 3, which is made easier now that they're all adjacent, and apply the background color of blue. Then apply a new sort, this time by the cells you had originally numbered sequentially. Your table will now have every third row in blue. Well, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.